My name is Susanna and I'm a student at Glyndwr University in Wrexham. I'm studying theatre, television and performance. Most people see me as a normal student, hardworking, committed, always on time, always willing to help, and I volunteer for most opportunities available, and like to keep busy by enjoying many hobbies such as crafting, reading, drawing, singing and many more. But there is one element of me that not many people see. I am dyslexic. I started life here on the beautiful Isle of Anglesey. My primary school was here in this little village called Benlloch. I did enjoy attending this primary school. There was one classroom assistant who would make sure I understood the work I was doing and made me feel so much more comfortable in the classroom. My secondary school was here in the town of Amloch. Here I got some help but didn't feel like I got the help I was entitled to. But I had some support if I needed it. Dyslexics all have different ways of learning. Me, I prefer to put what I am learning into practice. For example, if I'm learning a piece of script, I would prefer to be stood putting some action to it so that I can then go, right, that line goes with that action, or put a word from a song to a dance move that we've been given. Once I've got the hang of something, I can do it. And with practice, I can remember what I'm doing. It's like crafting. I've learned many new skills over the years, and at first I struggle really, really badly with it. But with practice, I can get the hang of it, and I'm improving every time I work on something.
Pan ish I ddod i brifysgol yn bwydig yn tes o'r chi o'n i'n 19 mlynedd oed.
I've always known, but officially when I was 18?
I think about 12.
Okay. Glyndwr University's Disability Support Centre can help support you with any support that you need. It is one of the top 5 universities for disability support. For me, here is where I've had the best support in the whole time I've been in education. When I arrived in my first year, I had my assessment and they told me not only did I have dyslexia, but I had an eye condition which was part of dyslexia called Erlen syndrome. They helped me to understand more and offer a wide range of support for dyslexic and can offer to help you by working out what would help you best and how it would benefit you best. So they would arrange to get the equipment you need to help you do well at university.
What do you do here at Glyndwr University?
My name is Jane Edwards and I work in student services in the disability team. So we support students with any type of individual need as a result of a disability.
Okay. How many students do you get up here for support?
We get a lot of students up here for support. Glyndwr is one of the top universities for the numbers of students who disclose disabilities. Last year there were 24.9% of our students in receipt of DSA. That's 1 in 4 of all the student population in receipt of DSA. So that's a lot because we don't think we actually catch everybody either.
What support is available for students with dyslexia?
Okay, the main disability that's disclosed is dyslexia and learning differences. It's probably about 9 out of 10 students who disclose disabilities. First of all, they may not know if they're dyslexic or not, so we can arrange for them to see an educational psychologist. Then we can help them through the process of applying for DSA, Disabled Student Allowance. DSA is Disabled Student Allowance. It's a grant, it's not a loan. It's there to support students with any individual needs. So it could provide things like assistive software, voice recorders, dyslexia tutor support, sign language interpreters, whatever it is that a student needs, that's what we can put in place through DSA.
Okay. Would you say Glyndwr University is one of the best universities for support for students with disabilities?
Okay. Going back to the figure of 24.9%, it's probably in the top five in the country, so yes. I think our strength is that we offer a culture of inclusion as far as we can, and we make our service as accessible as possible, and we don't use agency staff. All the staff that we use here that are in the team, that the dyslexia tutors, are all on board and employed by Glyndwr, and so are our learning support assistants who are note takers or help us in class and things like that. Our library support assistants, they all are employed by Glyndwr.
Is there anything else you'd like to say about disability support here?
We think that disability support is good in Glyndwr, but we always know that we can do better, and we're always asking students about how we can improve our service. So it's very much a two-way support service. So we want to know what's going to work for students as well, and we do listen to students.
I fod yn ystod, dwi heb ddefnyddio llawer o ychylwysterau sy'n cael. Dwi wedi cael offer gyda nhw, gysi laptop, a dictaphone, a printer o fi, mi wedi bod yn help.
A lot, yeah, but there was more options with extensions and things like that that I could have applied for, but I never did. I didn't want to be any different, more the others.
Quite a lot, yeah. They offer me extra time in the exams, free printing costs, book costs, free laptop, software, that sort of stuff.
It goes to show if there is the right support out there for you, then you can succeed no matter what anyone says about you. I've proved myself that with the right support, I can do well at university. According to Dyslexia Action, approximately 10% of the population are thought to have dyslexia, 4% being severely affected. Since the age of 9, I've loved performing, and have performed in numerous shows, mainly pantomimes and musicals. When I started performing at the age of 9, it gave me the confidence to put myself forward for more things. It's also given me a career path to follow. My favourite performance has to be working with a peer at university on a short directing piece, which was Spring Awakening. This was my favourite because I had to challenge myself and do some difficult scenes. But the thing I suffered the most on is learning and remembering my lines. One element of dyslexia is short-term memory. It proves difficult when you are in an environment where you have to remember everything you've been working on. With me, if we are working on a dance once that music starts, I will be fine and can remember it. With lines, I will doubt myself that I don't know it and get myself all stressed out about doing it, but then when I get into my costume and become that character, all the words come flooding back to me and I am fine. Many dyslexics are creative and a lot of them go on to act. Most drama schools report that 30% of their students are dyslexic. There are many famous dyslexics. Whoopi Goldberg, who's best known for a fantastic role in the musical Sister Act, is a dyslexic. Channing Tatum, who is best known for his role in Magic Mike, is a dyslexic. Shane Lynch, who is best known for being a part of Boyzone, is a dyslexic. Famous inventor Albert Einstein was dyslexic, and he said, "Everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb trees, it will live its whole life believing it is stupid." And the two final actors I'm going to mention are an inspiration to me, Cara Toynton, who's best known as Dawn from EastEnders, and Henry Winkler, who's best known as the Fonz from Happy Days.
This... You know what? You're always sticking your nose in and you ain't got a clue.
Privately, she's amongst the 1 in 10 Brits born with dyslexia, which means she struggles to read.
A company, or severally wounded of severely wounded.
Cara Toynton released her documentary in July 2010. This documentary really helped me to understand dyslexia more and how an actor can still succeed even if they are struggling. She shows in her documentary that if you try, you can find other ways of dealing with it even when you are an adult. She inspired me to keep going and to get help at every opportunity. Sky, hello blue, there's nothing can hold me when I hold you. It feels so right, it can't be wrong, rocking and rolling all week long. Many of you know this theme, but if you don't, it's the 70s 80s TV series Happy Days. Henry Winkler, well known for his role in Happy Days as the Fonz, is an inspirational to me because he only found out that he was dyslexic at the age of 31 and is going into schools to talk about dyslexia. He has even written his own book. This made me think about how lucky I was to be told I had dyslexia at a young age. But he shows that no matter how old you are, when you are told you are dyslexic, it shouldn't dishearten you, but it should make you proud because you have been able to achieve a lot with this hidden problem.
Well, you can hear, Henry, the reaction from the kids you were talking to there.
It is one of the best things I've ever done in my life, outside of my family, is to go into these classrooms, into the schools, and just be one-on-one with these kids. It's just, it, there is no altruism. It's not like, oh, I'm doing a good thing because I get so much out of it.
And tell us what inspired you, because you found out that you had dyslexia, but way late on in your life.
Right, I found out when I was 31. You know what inspired me? Here's the thing. I felt horrible growing up. I always felt on the outside. I always felt like I was stupid, like I couldn't figure out concepts. And my message is, you have greatness in you. Not one of the children sitting here does not have greatness in them. And it is really important that they know that, and that school is the law. Maybe school is difficult, but when you get out, you soar like an eagle.
On a day-to-day basis, I can change. Some days I can be doing really well, can really concentrate, and others I can go downhill and not understand anything that is happening or what I need to do. So when I wake up in the morning, I never know if I'm going to be able to have a good day or if I'm going to have a bad day and not understand anything that is being said to me. When I am in lectures, I have numerous pieces of equipment to help me, such as a LiveScribe pen. It enables me to write down notes in the lectures, but it also records what I am doing around me. So if I can't think of what a lecturer has said or what something means in my notes, I use the pen to play back what has recorded. I also have special coloured paper to write things down on, a little LED lamp so when presentations are on the screen and the lights are off, I can still see what I'm doing. Erlen's glasses so to help me in the classroom with the whiteboard and the lighting. These things are all things that help me in the classroom environment to make sure I can do the best I can in these situations. At home, I use my glasses and notepaper, but because I have a laptop quite a lot, I have a special software to help me with my research and essay writing. There are four different softwares to help me in different ways. Text Help Read and Write is a toolbar across the top of my screen. There are a number of different options. For example, there is screen overlays to make my screen change colour, and a dictionary that will help you give an explanation of a word so you can find the right spelling you are looking for. Then I have Dragon Naturally Speaking, which is a software that comes with a microphone headset. It's a bit like Text Help Read and Write, being a toolbar across the top of the screen, but this one dictates everything I am saying, which means I can write down what I am thinking that makes sense. I speak it to the software and it will write down on a document for me. It also takes commands. For example, open my documents, and it will open it for me. The next piece of software works with my LiveScribe pen. It's the LiveScribe desktop, which makes sure that all that has been recorded is saved to my laptop and I can rename them and find which lecture I want to go back to. Now, my favourite piece of equipment is Inspiration. Inspiration is a software that helps me to make spider diagrams or mind maps. So, for example, here is a mind map I made for my post-war British drama essay last year. Obviously, this is a big mind map, so when I printed it off, there was 4 pieces of paper and I stuck it to the wall and highlighted points that I thought would be useful in my essay. Other things I use to help me are notebooks with coloured paper to do spellings, practice handwriting, difficult words and things like that. All my equipment is so helpful to me and makes me feel so much more comfortable when I am writing my essays and doing research. To help me along on my journey, I need to have ways of relaxing and taking breaks. And most people do this by doing something they enjoy, like a hobby. Some dyslexics have strange hobbies. Me, I love to do anything crafty and arty. Every Wednesday I go to a craft and chat, which is an evening where you take your craft and go and socialise. I'm always trying new crafts, like in September I decided to try my hand at glass painting, and I did some pieces for my family for Christmas. My favourite craft has to be cross stitching. So many people say to me, how can you work on something so small? But I do it to relax, and most of the time I make things to give or sell to people. A dyslexic person can only use one side of their brain. This image shows a dyslexic using the right side of their brain, which is the more creative side.
Gad fi feddwl. Mae theatr yn un beth, a lot o bobl dwi'n apod yn meddwl bod licio theatr yn rhyfedd. Dwi'n licio cerddoriaeth eitha rhyfedd, cerddoriaeth psychedelic, a bych chi eitha sari pobl ddim yn licio.
Do I have a hobby that other people find weird?
What's
that? Do I have a hobby that other people find weird?
Sports.
Oh no, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that. But there's other people that like doing that.
A hobby?
Yeah.
I don't know.
No.
That's an interesting question. I don't know, it's what I've noticed since being in university is some of my flatmates, the hobbies that I have are unusual to them, but when I'm back home they're absolutely standard. Yeah. You know, working with tools, chainsawing, that sort of stuff. That's, to me, I like doing that sort of stuff, but to my friends here that's considered unusual. No, I wouldn't say I have got an unusual hobby. No, I'm quite enough.
Yeah.
I have to do a lot of things.
I am now in the progress of deciding what I want to do after I graduate university. I have 3 different paths in mind. I'm thinking of going back to college and getting an electrical qualification, which is my other passion. And it will mean I can work on theatre electrics, and it is also my backup plan. Another idea is to work in theatre and education, because I'd love to love to teach whilst performing. And the final idea I have is to work with a pantomime company. Pantomimes are one of my favourite types of theatre, and this is where I started in theatre, and it would be I would love to do it as a career.
Since coming to university, not only have I learnt to live independently and make new friends, but I've also learnt that I can do whatever I want to do, and not to let anyone get in my way. And I shouldn't give up on what my dreams are. Don't let anyone tell you what you can and can't do, because you are the one who knows your limits. You are the person who wants to do that. Never, ever let anyone get in your way.
So my advice to anyone with dyslexia is never give up on your dreams. You can do whatever you want to do, if you just believe in yourself. Go and reach for the stars and don't give up until you've achieved what you really want to do.
I can't really explain it. I haven't got the words. It's a feeling that you can't control. I suppose it's like forgetting, losing who you are. But at the same time, something makes you whole. It's like that there's music playing in your ear. And I'm listening, and I'm listening, and then I disappear. And then I feel a change, like a fire deep inside. Something bursting me wide open, impossible to hide. And suddenly I'm flying, flying like a bird. Like electricity, electricity. Sparks inside of me, and I'm free, I'm free. It's a bit like being angry, it's a bit like being scared. Confused and all mixed up and mad as hell. It's like when you've been crying and you're empty and you're full. But I don't know what it is, it's hard to tell.